Hello, and welcome to another episode of Xact Hacks, brought to you by Actionable Insights. My name is Seth Harrison, and today I want to talk about requesting a price list in X1. In the jump from Xactimate 28 to X1, there are some changes to the user interface, where things are laid out. So I thought it'd be a good idea, after some of our classes, to shoot a video on how to request a price list in X1 and the different ways that we can do that. As you can see here, I have X1 open, and I'm going to jump to the Preferences tab here and jump down to Pricing. And at the very top, you'll see the price list information here. Now note, these are the settings for my Xactimate. So if I were to come here and select a price list right in this window, I'm gonna hit this three tab here, and hit this open. If I select a price list here, it's going to apply that price list to every estimate I open. And then I would have to change it from there. For those of you that do use custom price lists, this is where you would select that custom price list to be used on the estimates you're generating. But in this particular video, we're just trying to request a price list. So down here, you'll see after I click that three lines, the menu button, I can now request a price list. And you can request it by city or zip code or specifically by name. If you know the nomenclature of Xactimate price lists, a CASD, for example, would be a California San Diego price list. What I'm going to do here is specifically go with the location that I know best. I always like to go by zip code. We'll use 92109, it pre-populated. I want today's date, so for the current price list in July, that's what I would put there. If I wanted a previous price list, I could go back to June. Let's say I want to download the June 2020 price list here. I would like it in English, and I don't need it to a specific profile. You can define that this price list would be assigned to carrier profile or contractor profile specifically. But here I want it really accessible on both. I just want the price list. When I hit download, it's going to download. Let's see how my internet connection here is. Oh, not bad. San Diego done. Now I have June 2020 right there available to me. Now I can select the price list here. Note that it would make all of my price lists that June 2020 price lists, or at least whenever I create a new estimate, it would use my checkpoint price list, or I shouldn't say checkpoint because that's a different thing. The actual price list right here would be what was used. Lastly, you can request a price list from within an estimate while you're working on it. I'm going to jump over to my local tab here, open up an estimate. I'm going to bring it up to the menu up here. And you'll see under the claim info, under the parameters tab, there is a price list. And here's where I can define the specific estimate price list. But if I wanted to download a price list right here, right now, while I'm in the estimate, I can come hit this drop-down box for the price list, come to the smart list in blue, and right here you're going to see that same button in format. Request a price list, download it by location or zip code, etc. So this has been a tutorial on requesting price lists and downloading them from Xactimate, from Xactaware, and putting them in your X1. Hope this gives you a tutorial that you can use, share amongst each other when trying to figure out, hey, I need the new price list. How can I get it in X1? Here you go. Xact Hack for you. Hope you've enjoyed. Please, whatever platform you're watching this on, social media, etc., give us a like, give us a share. It helps out a long way, and we'll be seeing you real soon.